Hi, Casey. Hi, Coco. Well, we're trying our best to pull in Senator Miriam Santiago and as well as Senator Pia Cayetano to get their thoughts and their emotions after this, really lengthy, the debates and the period of amendments. And even although the votes were shorter than people expected, as we all saw live on ANC, how the votes swiftly went through after the 25, or actually it turned out to become 33 amendments that were proposed by Senator Tito Soto. 27 of them were approved, 3 of them were rejected, and 3 of them were amended as well. It's an interesting moment to be here, Casey. If you're one amongst the gallery, you see a split of the supporters. You see people supporting the RH bill wearing purple. They were very, very supportive all throughout. People in red, as well as some of the people from the religious sectors, were there as well. Interesting to note, though, that once the votes were taken, there were some members of the gallery wearing red who just opted to walk out and opted to not sit through the rest of the third reading voting, wherein pretty much nothing changed. If I can hold on for a minute or so, I see Senator Santiago walking my way. We'll be grabbing her in a bit, but we did note some very emotional moments where the senators explained their votes and gave their reasons why they voted yes or no. Beside me right now, Senator Santiago. Good evening, ma'am. We have Coco Alcuaz and Carmina Constantino in the studio. Ma'am, first of all, how do you feel right now being the co-sponsor of this bill?
But also, very gratified that so many women came in purple. And you can see very clearly for yourself that they come from the underprivileged classes. Mm-hmm. So it's a difficulty in itself for them to come to the Senate, much less to buy purple blouses. But that's how strongly they feel. Mm-hmm. So when we won, we felt very elated that we had, in our view, given voice to the voiceless.
One of your statements that actually trended on Twitter earlier was you said you can buy tons of condoms, but a woman in Tondo cannot. How do you feel that this is one of those words that you really want to resonate out to the public, that how important this bill is for the poor women?
It is extremely important. We tend to overlook it because so many things are available to us. And in effect, they live in an entirely different universe altogether. One we are not familiar with, where they have only a few feet by 4 feet, and they all have to live there together without water or electricity and food on the table, much less the money to buy condoms. So you cannot imagine the misery of these people. Some channels have been very kind and have investigated, by means of investigative documentaries, the situation of these poor women. We have to go to the universe of the poor to understand the importance and the magnitude, and most importantly, the impact of this bill on the lives of the poor. Mm-hmm.
Understanding the other side, though, ma'am, that they were saying that the money could be spent in other means to address the same problem, whether giving it to education, giving more scholarships, addressing the sanitation of some of the hospitals. How do you respond to that, that they're saying that the almost 4 billion pesos could be spent in other ways?
It's a question of prioritizing. Mm-hmm. That's all that governance does. It just decides what priorities should be given priority in funding, mm-hmm. because all of them are priorities. So we have to pick and choose. We have no choice. If we are faced with the fact that 13 to 15 women die every single day out of sheer ignorance during childbirth, then that is sufficient to make reproductive health bill the highest priority for our budget in these times. We all acknowledge the priority that should be given to others items in the agenda, but we have to acknowledge that this one causes actual death. It does not cause only injury or damage or inconvenience or discomfort, it causes death.
Well, we want to thank you for joining us, ma'am, and I'm not sure if I can hear Coco or Casey in the studio.
Yes.
Casey, Coco, can you?
Yes, TJ, we actually have one question for the good senator.
Okay, I've lost communication with him, but thank you so much. All the best, and we'll be monitoring the developments in the bicam as well. Thank you.
Anytime you want to run for senator.
Well, thank you,
just
ma'am.
Tell me, I'll endorse you immediately.
Right. Thanks for the amusement. Thank you, ma'am. All right, Casey, Coco, topping it off with a funny comment as well. We're still trying to get Senator Pia Cayetano as well to join us. That's it for now. I'll be throwing it back to you, and we'll see if we can get you more guests here.
Jay Manok up there, coming to us live from the Senate. Thanks for that, Coco.
Thanks very much. We have this just in, a statement from the palace thanking lawmakers for the passage of the RH bill. Here's what the statement says. Our legislature took an historic vote today for women and families as it successfully passed the reproductive health bill. They've made it even clearer that people now have the government on their side as they raise their families in a manner that is just and empowered. The statement adds that the passage of the Responsible Parenthood Bill signals not only a new chapter in our agenda of